Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Origin of the Mages Guild, which I bought right here at the Odd Hawk Shop in Longwich Commons, which is in Alessan Hills. The Origin of the Mages Guild. The idea of a collection of mages, sorcerers, and assorted mystics pooling their resources and talents for the purpose of research and public charity was a revolutionary concept in the early years of the Second Era. The closest organization to what we today know as the Mages Guild was the Sigic Order of the Isle of Artaim. Magic was something to be learned by individuals, or, at most, in intimate covens. Mages were, if not actual hermits, usually quite solitary. The Sigic Order served the rulers of the Somerset Isle as counselors and chose its members by a complex ritualized method not understood by the common people. Its purposes and goals were likewise unpublished, and its detractors attributed the worst evil as the source of its power. The religion of the Old Order could be described as ancestor worship, an increasingly unfashionable philosophy in the Second Era. When Vanus Galarian, a Sigic of Artaim and student of the famed Iacessus, began collecting mages from around Somerset Isle, he attracted the animosity of all. He was operating out of First Hold, and there was a common, and not entirely unsensible, attitude that magical experiments should be conducted only in unpopulated areas. Even more shocking, Galarian proposed to make magical items, potions, and even spells available to any member of the general public who could pay. No longer was magic to be limited either to the aristocracy or intelligentsia. Galarian was brought before Iacessus and the King of First Hold, Rillis XII, and made to state the intentions of the guild he was forming. The fact that Galarian's speech to Rillis and Iacessus was not recorded for posterity is a tragedy, though it does allow the opportunity for historians to amuse one another with lies and persuasions Galarian might have used to found the ubiquitous organization. The charter was approved. Almost immediately after the guild was formed, the question of security had to be answered. The Isle of Artaim did not have to have a force of arms to shield it from invaders interested in stealing its treasures. When the Sigic Order does not wish someone to land on the island and all on it become insubstantial. The new Mages Guild had to hire guards. Galarian soon discovered what nobles have known for thousands of years. Money alone does not buy loyalty. The Knightly Order of the Lamp was formed the following year. Like a tree from an acorn, the Mages Guild grew branches all over Somerset Isle and then to the mainland of Tamriel. There are many records of superstitious or sensibly fearful rulers forbidding the guild in their kingdom, but their heirs or their heirs' heirs recognized the wisdom of allowing the guild to practice. The Mages Guild was a powerful force in Tamriel, a dangerous foe if a somewhat disinterested ally. There have only been a few rare incidents of the Mages Guild actually becoming involved in local political struggles. On these occasions, the guild's participation has been the ultimate decider in the conflict. By tradition, begun by Vanus Galarian, the Mages Guild as a singular institution is presided over by a council of 6 archmagisters. Each guild location is run by a guild magister, assisted by a council of 2, the Master of Incunnubula and the Master at Arms. The Master of Incunnubula presides over a council of an additional 2 mages, the Master of Academia and the Master of the Scry. The Master at Arms also has a council of 2, the Master of Initiates and the Palatinus, the leader of the Order of the Lamp. One need not be a member of the Mages Guild to know that this carefully constructed order is often nothing more than an illusion. As Vanus Galarian himself said bitterly, leaving Tamriel to travel to other lands, the guild has become nothing more than an intricate morass of political infighting. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, Origin of the Mages Guild.